Hello, and welcome to our demo video. Today, we're going to walk you through the process of setting up and managing a call center with PortaSwitch. First, let's create a new call center. Navigate to the Customers menu and click Create. Let's give this call center a name, Help Desk 365, set a credit limit, and a corresponding time zone. All right. Next, you can add the billing information and contact details and define terms and conditions for the call center services. Let's select 30 call center seats and one call center IVR. Now, let's enable dialing rules allowing call center employees to make outgoing calls and use service codes. Finally, we can enable advanced hunt group tracking for Help Desk 365 that will help the call center efficiently use the automated call distribution to agents via ring groups. Next, we'll assign an administrator to manage our call center. Let's select the allowed role and then simply go to the Customer Individuals tab, click on Add New, and input the administrator's details. Voila! This call center is almost ready to roll. Now, let's switch to the perspective of the call center administrator. After logging in, you can view the licenses available to your call center. You can see that Help Desk 365 can have up to 30 seats and one auto attendant to handle incoming calls. Let's add some direct inward dialing, or DID number, to our call center. These are needed for clients to reach the call center with their questions and issues. Navigate to the inventory menu and find DID number. Click Add New, select the country, area, and pick the available DID number. Great! The call center has IP phones they had already purchased. So let's import those devices to the inventory to get them auto-provisioned. In the inventory menu, select Devices and choose to import devices from a file. When the upload is complete, the IP phones from this pool can be assigned to the call center employees' extensions for auto-provisioning. Next, we'll add ring groups so that the call center can more efficiently distribute calls among agents. In the Ring Groups menu, click Add New and set the details for your ring group, including its short number and the ringing strategy. Now, the administrator can configure the automated call wrap-up scheduling. By doing so, the call center sets the time agents have to complete after-call work. That means less stress for agents and higher overall performance for the call center. Moving on to call queues. In the call queues settings, let's enable the call queue for support. Here, the administrator can define how to handle the busy call queue by providing callers with additional options, for example, to leave a voicemail instead of making callers wait in a seemingly endless call queue. All right. Looks like we are ready to add agents to the call center. Just navigate to Extensions and click Download to get a sample CSV file. If the call center migrates from another call center solution, most likely the administrator has a list of employees that can be added to a file. Let's upload such a CSV file with the agent's details. There we go. When the call center hires a new agent, the administrator can add a new extension manually by defining an extension, which is a short internal number, selecting a product, and optionally assigning an IP phone. Now let's grant the supervisor permissions to this new employee. First, let's add them to the ring group and check the supervisor box. This will allow this new user to access other agents' calls. Let's now configure our call center settings. Open the Call Settings menu and set the main company number that will be displayed as a caller identity for outgoing calls made from all of the phone lines. Next, we can enable call supervision so that Help Desk 365 can ensure the highest level of quality for the services they provide. Supervisors will be able to join active calls in spy, whisper, and barge-in modes depending on the situation. Next, we'll configure the Interactive Voice Response, IVR, and Automated Call Distribution, ACD. The ACD system seamlessly manages incoming calls, intelligently routes them, and ensures efficient call queuing, providing a foundation for exceptional customer service. The IVR is a technology facilitating user interaction with an automated system before connecting them with an agent. IVR aids in identifying the nature of the user's query, directing them to the appropriate assistance. IVRs achieve this by prompting users to press specific keys on their phones corresponding to their needs. For instance, an IVR might instruct, "Press 1 for product purchases." Subsequently, the ACD processes this input, linking users with relevant sales agents and avoiding unnecessary transfers to unrelated departments. Navigate to the Auto Attendance menu. Click Add New and configure your IVR according to your business hours. The call flow visualizes how incoming calls will be handled within business hours and after hours when the call center may be closed. For example, callers will hear an announcement after hours and will be disconnected, while they will be connected to call queue support or redirected to sales during the business hours depending on their choice. That's simple. Now, let's configure the wallboard that displays key call center metrics. It can be customized to show the information that's most important for Help Desk 365. The administrator can add different widgets and open the wallboard in full screen mode so that all the employees can see it, for example, on the wall-mounted screen. Let's switch to PortaPhone Web, the application that can be used by call center agents to handle calls directly in the browser. Let's answer our first call and talk to a client. During the call, we have the option to stop the call recording at any time. This can be useful when a client provides sensitive data that must never be recorded. So the agent enters the service code and the call recording is stopped immediately. Back on the call console, we can view all the current calls. Managers have the ability to control these calls. For instance, they can join, mute, hold, or even end the calls. As a supervisor, you can join an active call to provide real-time assistance to your agents. Just dial one of the service codes followed by the agent's extension from your dial pad. Let's take a look at the wallboard again. Here, you can see an overview of your call center's activity, including the available agents. Next, we'll check out the call statistics. This section provides detailed reports on your call center's performance, such as call durations and call abandon rate for incoming calls. The data can also be easily downloaded as a report. Finally, let's play some of our call recordings. Navigate to the Call Recordings menu. Select a recording and click Play. And that's it. As you can see, setting up and managing a call center with our solution is straightforward and efficient. If you have any questions or need further assistance, don't hesitate to contact us. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.